So guys, this is the most important topic of thermodynamics. The topic is degrees of freedom. From this topic, questions are asked everywhere in examination for your competitive exams. Now, questions can be asked both from physics point of view as well as from chemistry point of view. Now, let's explain the concept, that is degree of freedom. Now, see, if we have a molecule, our molecule can have how many degrees of freedom? How many types of motions can our molecule have? How our molecule can move, how many specified positions are for our molecule to move. Let us say this is x-axis, let us say this is y-axis, and let us say this is z-axis. Our molecule can move along this direction, our molecule can show motion along this direction, our molecule can show motion along this direction. These are translational motions. See, if this is my z-axis, and this is my x-axis, and this is my y-axis, then my molecule can move along this direction, it can move along this direction, it can move along this direction. Means my molecule can translate in three possible directions. Therefore, the molecule which is given to us or any other molecule that can have translational degree of freedom. Translational degree of freedom. That can have translational degree of freedom. That can have translational degree of freedom. How many types of translational degrees of freedom? There will be three. Now, I will write translational degree of freedom NTR. This is translational degree of freedom. It is for every molecule. These are equal to 3. Now, see one more type of motion. Our molecule can have rotational motion as well. This is our molecule. It can rotate along this bond axis. Molecule is rotating along this bond axis. Now, this is called a rotational degree. This is called a rotational degree. There is one more degree. Then that is called, this is first degree of motion. Then the second one is called a rotational degree of motion. Rotational degree. Rotational degree. Now see, my molecule can rotate along this axis. It can rotate like this, or it can rotate like this, or it can rotate like this. Therefore, we can have three rotational degrees in certain molecules. In certain molecules too. I will write rotational degrees as NROT, that is rotational degree of freedom. They differ from linear, for linear and non-linear molecules. Now there are one more type of motion for the molecules. We can stretch our molecule and we can bend our molecule. That's called vibrational degree of motion of a molecule. Our molecule can have vibrational degree as well. We can have number third type of degree of freedom, that is vibrational, that's N vibration. Vibrational degrees of freedom. Now see, let us see how many types of degree of freedom are possible for a molecule. Now see, there is a formula. For a molecule, there can be total 3n degrees of freedom. There can be total 3n degrees of freedom. For any molecule, there are total 3n degree of freedom. 3n degree of freedom, where n is the number of atoms. N stands for number of atoms. N stands for number of atoms. For example, if we have carbon dioxide, number of atoms are 3, 2 oxygen, 1 carbon. Therefore, N is equal to 3. There will be total 3 into 3, that's 9 degrees of freedom. For example, if we have a methane molecule, N is here 5, 4 hydrogen atoms, 1 carbon, N is equal to 5. There can be 3 into 5, that is 15 degrees of freedom. For example, if we have a compound like benzene, in benzene, there are 6 carbon atoms and 6 hydrogen atoms. Total number of atoms are how many? Total number of atoms are 6 carbon and 6 hydrogen atoms, that is 12. Therefore, N is equal to 12. Total degrees of freedom is 3 into 12, that is 36. Total degrees of freedom. Now, out of these 3N degrees of freedom, these are contributed by rotational degree, vibrational degree and translational degree. Means this 3N degree of freedom, it will be equal to N translational, because our molecule can show translational motion, plus N rotation, because our molecule can rotate, plus N vibration, because our molecule can vibrate. These are equal to 3N degrees of freedom. Now we have two types of molecules. We have linear molecules and non-linear molecules. We have linear molecules and non-linear molecules. Non-linear molecules. Now, what do we mean by linear and non-linear? We can determine whether they are linear or non-linear on the basis of Weber theory and hybridization. If the bond angle between two atoms in a molecule, if it is 180, then they are linear, otherwise they are not non-linear, otherwise they are non-linear. For every type of molecule, whether linear or non-linear, n translational is equal to 3. N translational is equal to 3. N translation is equal to 3. But for linear molecules, there are only two rotational vibrations. For linear molecules, n rotational is equal to 2. And for non-linear molecules, n rotation is equal to 3. Now, substituting this in this equation, we get, for linear molecules, what we get? For linear molecules, we get n translational, that is n translational plus n rotational plus n vibrational is equal to 3n. N translational for linear molecules is 3, n rotational for linear molecules is 2, plus n vibrational is equal to 3n. 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. Vibrational degrees of freedom for a linear molecule, it is 3n minus 5. This becomes a general formula. For a linear molecule, vibrational degrees of freedom are 3n minus 5. Now, in this case, when a molecule is non-linear, translational degrees are 3, n translational plus n rotational plus n vibrational is equal to 3n. Now, n translational is 3, n rotational is 3, n vibrational we can determine, that will be equal to 3n. Therefore, vibrational degrees of freedom will be 3n minus 6. Now, we have two types of vibrational degrees of freedom, for linear molecules and for non-linear molecules. For linear molecules and for non-linear molecules, we will write it over here. Total degrees of freedom are 3n. For linear molecules, vibrational degrees of freedom, n vibrational, it's equal to 3n minus 5. And for non-linear molecules, vibrational degrees of freedom is equal to 3n minus 6. This is for non-linear molecules. Now see, there is one more important point. For transition states in organic chemistry, we usually see these transition states. For transition states, the value changes. This becomes equal to 3n minus 6, 1 degree is more, and this becomes equal to 3n minus 7 for transition status. This is very important. Although this may not be asked in exams like your medical exams and JEE exams, this is asked in GATE exams. For transition status, linear molecules, we have 3n minus 6 vibrational degree of freedom and 3n minus 7 vibrational degree of freedom for non-linear molecules. Now see, let us discuss a relationship between degree of freedom and CV. Now what is our CV? CV, relation between degree of freedom and CV. Or we can determine from this equation, we can determine gamma. Gamma is equal to ratio of Cp by Cv. This is asked in competitive exams. You are given a molecule and you are asked what is gamma for the molecule. Cp by Cv. We will determine it using law of equipartition of energies. Law of equipartition of energies. This is a physics concept. Equipartition of energies. Law of equipartition of energies. Now, I will simplify this concept. I will not go into the details of this concept. We will only solve questions by simplifying this. Now, see, law of equipartition of energies. We have three types of motions. We have translational degree of freedom. We have rotational degree of freedom. And we have vibrational degree of freedom. We will see contribution towards CV. Now, symbol for this is n translation, symbol for this is n rotation, symbol for this is n vibration. Now, contribution for CV, it's R by 2, contribution for CV, it's R by 2, and contribution for CV, there are two types of contributions, at low temperature and at high temperature. At low temperature, it is R. And at high temperature, it is 0.2 R. At high temperature, it is 0.2 R. By low temperature, I mean that room temperature. At low temperature, it is R, and at high temperature, it is 0.2 R. Now see, this is according to law of equipartition of energies. Translational degrees of freedom have contribution towards CV R by 2, and rotational have R by 2. Vibrations have two types of contribution. They behave differently. At low temperature, it's R. And at high temperature, it is 0.2 R. It is R and it is 0.2 R at high temperature. At high temperature, it is 0.2 R. And at low temperature, it is R. At high temperature, it is 0.2 R. At low temperature, it is 0.2 R. At low temperature, it is 0.2 R. Now, what we have seen over here, we have seen and translational, and rotational, and vibrational. For this, contribution of CV is R by 2, contribution is R by 2, contribution may be R, or 0.2 R. This is at low temperature. This is at high temperature, This is at high temperature, and this is at low temperature. Now we will determine total CV, CV total for linear molecules and for non-linear molecules. We will determine total CV. Total CV will be equal to contribution of this plus contribution of this plus contribution of this. Now total CV will be equal to N translational into R by 2 plus N rotational into R by 2 plus N vibrational into R if it is at high temperature. And at low temperature, CV total will be equal to N translational R by 2 plus N rotational R by 2 plus N vibrational 0.2 R. This is at low temperature. At room temperature. Now let us discuss a question. Determine the degrees of freedom for methane molecule at high temperature and derive a relationship between Cp and Cv, that is gamma. Determine gamma, that is Cp by Cv, for methane molecule at high temperature. High temperature signifies only that contribution of vibration is R. Now let us determine it at high temperature. Now see, we have a methane molecule. For this methane molecule, total number of atoms is equal to 5. Total degrees of freedom will be 3N, that is 3 into 5, that will be equal to 15. Total degrees of freedom are 15. Now see, it is not linear molecule, it's a non-linear molecule. This is for both linear and non-linear molecules. This is not linear molecule, it's a non-linear molecule. For non-linear molecule, vibrational degrees of freedom is equal to 3N minus 6. What is 3N? It's 15 minus 6. 15 minus 6 is equal to 9. Therefore, we can substitute these values in this equation. There are, for non-linear molecules, translational degrees of freedom are equal to 3. Rotational degrees of freedom are equal to 3. And vibrational is equal to, for this molecule, it is 9. Now, substitute in this equation, we get Cv total, or Cv is equal to N of translational. How many translational degrees of freedom? 3. What's contribution? It's R by 2. Plus N of rotation. How many rotational degrees? 3. What's contribution? It's R by 2. Plus N of vibrational. What is vibration? N number. Number is 9. And contribution is R at high temperature. Now it will be equal to 3R by 2 plus 3R by 2 plus 9R. It will be equal to 3R by 2 plus 3R by 2, it becomes equal to 6R by 2 plus 9R. Now see, 2 1s are 2, 3s are 9, 3, 12, 12R. Then Cp comes out to be CV comes out to be CV is equal to 12R. Now there is a relation CP minus CV is equal to R. Now we know CV, we have to determine CP. CP is equal to R plus CV. Now R is over here R and CV is equal to 12R. That is equal to 13R. Now we can determine gamma. Gamma is equal to CP by CV. That is 13 by 12. R and R will go. This is 13 by 12. That's 1.08. For methane molecule at high temperature, gamma is equal to 1.08. We can solve one more question. Let me check the video length. We can solve one more question. Determine gamma for helium molecule. For helium atom, not molecule. Helium molecule does not exist. For helium at high temperature. At high temperature. Note down, at high temperature and vibrational contribution is taken to be R. Now we have to determine gamma for helium at high temperature. Now see, helium consists of only one atom. Therefore, total degrees of freedom will be 3N. That is 3 into 1, that will be 3. Now for every molecule, whether that is linear or non-linear or monoatomic or diatomic, what type of molecule? N translational is equal to 3. Now these 3 degrees of freedom are of translational motion. Then N vibrational, N rotational will be equal to 0. And N vibrational will be equal to 0. Therefore, CV total will be equal to this N translational into contribution of CV, that's R by 2. What's N translational? Number is 3, R by 2. This comes out to be CV. Now we know that CP minus CV is equal to R. Or CP is equal to R plus CV. That's R plus 3 by 2R. 2 ones are 2. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 by 2R. That's 5 by 2R. This is our CP and this is our CV. Now we can determine gamma. Determine gamma over here. Gamma will be equal to, that's the ratio of CP and CV. Gamma will be equal to CP by CV. Now CP is 5 by 2R and CV is 3R by 2. Now R and R will go. It's 5 by 2 into 2 by 3. Now this and this will go. It's 5 by 3. That is 3 ones are 3. 3 sixes are 1.66. Gamma for helium is equal to 1.66 at high temperature. Gamma for helium is equal to 1.66. Now the question in your competitive exams is asked like this. What will be the value of gamma for helium molecule, for nitrogen molecule, for neon molecule, for any molecule you have to determine gamma. And other questions that are asked like this, or you can practice these questions. That's a homework for you. Calculate N vibrational degrees of freedom for number first NO2, number second SO2, number third CO, number fourth SO3, number fifth CO2, number sixth CH4, number seventh N2, and number eighth O2. This is your homework. Determine the vibrational degrees of freedom. One I will do for you, NO2. See how we are going to determine NO2 molecule. Now NO2 molecule has this type of structure. It is not a linear structure. It has a bent structure. NO2 molecule, there are 2 and 1, 3 atoms. N is equal to 3. Therefore, total degrees of freedom is equal to 3N. 3 into 3 is 9. It's a nonlinear molecule, therefore N vibrational is equal to 3N minus 6. That means 9 minus 6, that means 3. You can determine for other molecules. Thanks for watching this lecture. If you like, then please do subscribe the channel. And press bell icon for further future notifications so that you may come to know that which lecture I am updating and which I have not updated till yet, so that I will come to know that which lectures are pending in any unit, I'll upload them. Thanks for watching.